Well, a Toronto program aimed to support and showcase black students is looking for continued funding from the Ministry of Education. It's called the READI program, and it aims to merge academic excellence with Afrocentric cultural immersion for students in kindergarten to grade 12. It finished in September, but organizers are hoping a funding boost will allow them to continue and expand throughout the Greater Toronto area. Our Natalie Collada tells us more.
It's a space and summer program that is not only readying black students for September, but also making them feel safe.
Like, sometimes I feel like my classmates, they would make some racist comments, and, like, I wouldn't like that, and, like, it's hurtful.
For 10-year-old Jeremiah Takiana, the READI program has made all the difference.
You can make lots of friends. It's great, and you can learn your black culture. You can learn about yourself.
And that, say organizers, is exactly the point.
Without a doubt, the statistics are showing that this model works. When you have black children in a program that is academically strong, with high expectations, coupled with a culturally affirming and safe space, they excel.
The program provides academic support and Afrocentric cultural immersion to ready black students for kindergarten to grade 12 for the upcoming school year.
My kids go to public school in York Region, and my son is in a French immersion school. So even more so for him, he doesn't see children that look like him, and he doesn't see educators that look like him. So coming to a program like this, even though it's only been a couple of weeks, is a spirit uplifting.
Martin says a survey of participants found 86% reported an increase in confidence and feeling safe. The need for the program not only to continue but expand, she says, is great.
We have parents that are coming as far away as Ajax. Parents are coming from Brampton, from downtown Toronto. We had a parent in Hamilton that wanted to come.
The program wraps up this week, but organizers hope it will be back next year. Natalie Collada, CBC News, Vaughan.